saying the same thing over and over, but there's a reason that it's there. God put it there. I don't really remember ever going back, such in the church, as I was growing up in church, my whole life, I don't remember anyone preaching all the way through the book of Proverbs. A pastor in Florida did preach a lot from Proverbs, but he didn't preach all the way through. So, I would like to, I think. And if you say, okay, that's enough, I've had enough, then just let me know that. We're going to start on Proverbs chapter 13. But remember, Proverbs and biblical promises. General wisdom. Teaching and encouraging. So God encourages us to do the right thing. How do you do the right thing? Well, you have this compared to this. And this represents a fool, and here is the wise person. So, duh. At the same time, we need to be reminded that Solomon was reminding himself that sometimes you're doing the foolish thing, so we need to remind ourselves. Chapter 15 through 21. Let's go ahead and read this. Understanding giveth favor, but the way of transgressors is hard. Every prudent man giveth with knowledge, but a fool layeth open his folly. A wicked messenger falleth into mischief, but a faithful ambassador is health. Poverty and shame shall be him that refuseth instruction, but he that regardeth reproof shall be honored. Desire accomplished is sweet to the soul, but it is abomination to fools to depart from evil. He that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Evil pursueth sinners, but to the righteous good shall be repaid. So, this is a good first here. I'm going to see if I have time to go through it all. probably the manager, I don't know. They come back out, oh, they approved this. Can you accept that? No. Car salesmen hate it when you waste their time. They don't make a profit. They make a profit out of people who are ignorant. They don't like to negotiate. They like to take advantage of people. So the prudent man is prepared, knows what to do. Fool believes whatever he's told. Which one do you want to do? It's your choice, obviously. 17. A wicked messenger falleth into mischief, but a faithful ambassador is help. So an ambassador. What is an ambassador? What do they do? Have you heard that from a foreign country? Maybe from Europe? A minister? For example, if I become the American ambassador to Japan, I go to Japan. Should I look like someone who's Japanese? I should look like what? An American. Why? So they will know what Americans look like. So when I go there and I say I'm an American, and America would like this and this and this, the Japanese will listen and say, okay, Americans would like this and this and this. We can negotiate. We can work together. Tell me your secret, and I'll share some of my secrets. Or we can work together and become a partner and build an alliance. So, as an ambassador, I can use that sign, I'm representative, an ambassador for America. And if I go there bribing, you know, suppose Russia bribes me and I take a bribe from Russia, well, that would be too much trouble. A wicked messenger, if I'm not faithful, if I'm not a good, faithful to my country, it's going to lead to trouble. And we see that in other countries where the ambassadors are taken bribes, and most of them end up being killed or shamed, or they have to go into hiding in another country. And we don't want that. So be faithful. A faithful messenger. So that's political. Now let's think about spiritual. Who do we represent? Whose ambassador are we? Should be an ambassador for Christ. And that means what? Who am I dealing with? For the world. The world should see me. And should I look like the world? Should I have to go on my church? Sorry, that's off the point. I'm sorry, off the point. Different, but I should. talking about a general messenger. We can apply this to the spiritual as well in our lives right now as Christians. In verse 18, poverty and shame shall be unto him that refuseth instruction. Now, again, which you want? A person who won't listen to teaching? Guess what? They're going to be poor. They're going to be ashamed. Because they don't listen. They don't learn. They don't accept instruction. And I'll tell you, your pastor is still learning. I must be open to learning myself. I must be willing to listen. And not just say, follow whatever I say. We can all learn. It doesn't matter how old you are. Teddy Chang, are you still learning? He's still learning. You never stop. Why? To accept reproof and be in honor. If you don't listen, you won't get any honor. You'll be ashamed and you'll be poor. If you want to learn and mature and grow, then you'll succeed. It's not guaranteed. Proverbs is a book of general wisdom. But in general, you should continue to learn until you die. So, verse 19. The desire accomplished is sweet to the soul. Now, hold on. Any of you ever had a project at home? Big job. Except for this one thing. I don't want you to have this. I've house, you can have it. Except this one thing.
Right.
I don't want to give that up.
That's a fool.
That's a fool. Why? I don't want to leave my evil. Verse 20. Maybe the most important verse for us to think about. Who do you want to spend time with? A fool, if you stay fooled all the time, guess what? You'll make dumb decisions. When I was growing up, I had several friends. They weren't really close in high school. I didn't have many close friends. My best friend, I didn't really have a best friend. I had several friends in the church, but not really close. And some of my friends were on sports teams. But not really close, because I saw the decisions that they made. And I didn't want to be with them. I made better decisions. Sometimes I made dumb decisions too. I'll save that story for another day. But I saw the decisions that they made, who they hung out with at parties, and I can't tell you how many times I suggested, you know, while I worked with them, I went to the grocery store. And there were lots of teenagers. Say, oh, come on and smoke pot tonight. And I said, no, we're not going to do that. Oh, you're a hypocrite. You're older now. I said, yeah, I am. And throughout all of that, I offered and offered and offered and refused. Every time they offered, I refused. I said, no, why? Because I didn't want to be a fool. some way, but they saw me and saw that I was different. In verse 21. I almost want to read this sentence backwards. It says, evil pursueth sinners, but to the righteous, good shall be repaid. So if I'm a sinner, and I'm staying in my sin, wise decisions or foolish ones, whether you're prepared, whether you're a bad messenger or a good representative, it should be easy to do all of these. Of course, we want the good. And sometimes it requires work and practice, and we have to sacrifice. Because the right way doesn't always feel good. The wrong way often feels good. We think it's going to be easy, but then we start getting frustrated. And the good way sometimes feels hard, but it's so much smoother in the end. If you're in a competition, from practice, it's going to be a tougher challenge. If you practice hard, then you're ready for the game. It's easier to be successful. Sometimes you just don't want to. You feel lazy. Thank you.